Fannie Willis requesting a March 4th trial date for President Trump and the 18 other defendants in the 2020 election case. Now, that date is just one day before what's called Super Tuesday, the busiest day in the Republican presidential nomination process. Meanwhile, special counsel Jack Smith is proposing Trump's trial to be on January 6th. That should start in January 2nd of next year, just weeks before the Iowa caucus and a month before the Nevada and South Carolina primaries. Joining us right now is former FBI Special Agent Nicole Parker. Nicole, it's great to see you. Thanks very much for being here this morning.
Thank you so much for having me, Maria.
And we talk all the time about your story. You left the FBI. You were a special agent there, but you saw the winds shifting at the FBI. What are your thoughts on the FBI's role in stopping Trump?
You know, this is a country where we're supposed to have law and order, and it should be based on facts, not political persuasion. And I just think over and over, we are seeing the criminal justice system being weaponized, and a very strong and aggressive investigations into those that hold certain political views more on the Republican and conservative side, but then those on the opposite end almost get a pass and they almost turn a blind eye. But Maria, thank you to the whistleblowers, both from the IRS and the FBI. These are noble and brave and courageous FBI agents who are coming forward, and they are speaking the truth. They are upholding their oath to the Constitution, and they are letting the American public know what is actually happening.
Yeah, I mean, the Fulton County Clerk of Court's office is now admitting to posting the Trump indictment online hours before a grand jury actually voted to indict him. Watch this.
I am human. I did a work sample in the system. And when I hit save, it went to the press queue. It wasn't an official document. It wasn't official charges. It was the dry run. It was a work sample. It was fictitious. It wasn't real. It didn't have a stamp on it. We just wanted to be transparent.
Yeah, so Nicole, they're still calling it fictitious, even though the charges were exactly the same as the actual indictment. Your thoughts?
You know, that's semantics. It's not fictitious. There's nothing fictitious about it. It was exactly the same thing, other than the fact that it didn't have the stamps and the seals on it. And for them to come forward and say, you know, I did that in error, I appreciate the honesty. But, you know, they were so eager to get that posted. You know, I wish that in all of my investigations that I conducted while an FBI agent, I wish that they were as aggressive in getting things done. I thought it was interesting that they had, again, this is the DA, this is not the DOJ and FBI, but we're seeing it across all criminal justice systems. They had an 11:30 press conference on a Monday evening. What was the necessity of that? And the fact that it was so important that this information was ready to be posted immediately. You know, you want to go back to motive. You want to think you've got the court of public opinion in this country, because this is an election that is at stake right now.
Yeah.
But when I run my cases, I want it to be the core of criminal proceedings, and that should be it. But that doesn't seem to be the case in this instance.
Yeah, I mean, new Fox News polls find nearly 40% of voters believe that Joe Biden did something illegal when it comes to his son's business deals, while 34% said that he did nothing seriously wrong. You've got another poll that says 50% of voters say that Hunter Biden did something illegal when it comes to his foreign business.
Join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.